Hello, everyone. I'm Greg Gumbel in New York. We are continuing our coverage on ESPN while CBS News provides special coverage of the war in Iraq. Let's send you now back out to the games.
From the East Regional here in Tampa, first round play as the 10th seeded Auburn Tigers leading 7th seeded St. Joseph's 26-15, 3:42 to go here in the first half. And St. Joe's just has not gotten into any kind of rhythm on the offensive end. Meanwhile, Auburn living up to its reputation. They are strong in the front court, and they have been able to control the interior, Jim.
Yeah, clearly the overview of this basketball game early on has been the ineffectiveness of St. Joe's on the perimeter on the offense, and that's attributed to Auburn's defense out there. West hits one shot from the outside, but really is struggling. He came into this game struggling with that stress fracture, and he really hasn't been able to show his true form. And right now it's a matter of St. Joseph's just trying to get through this half, play it tight, and West is going to lose that basketball in the corner after the ball hits off his foot.
Delonte West off his foot, the most improved player in the Atlantic 10 this season, but it has been a struggle. We know he's not 100%. Phil Martelli felt he was playing at about 70%. That's what he told us yesterday. And West earlier today said that this is the best he's felt in about a month. Stress fracture right fibula. Leaning attempt doesn't go for Nathan Watson. Now Lewis Monroe controls it. Here's Monroe.
Still looking to go to the blocks. Killingsworth in particular wants the basketball. He's moving very well down low. They just have to find him.
Monroe, shot clock down to 5. Shot clock down to 2. Killingsworth's jumper. Soft touch. Nelson, lead feed. It's tracked down by Jones.
See, that's a smart play just to catch the basketball. A lot of times, especially the big guys, will try to make something happen just then. And what they normally do is they bounce it out of bounds.
Nelson caught up along the baseline. Nelson will fire. No good.
Good job on the other side of the floor. Daniels blocking out against West, who had stuck along the baseline. Surprised Daniels really hasn't gone after West with this problem.
Here's Killingsworth using his body. Off the back in by Daniels. Turns inside. No call. Shot on the interior.
All right, did Barley ever take a shot just then with Daniels inadvertently slamming an elbow into his face.
And Barley trying to shake it off. As he comes up the floor, Nelson handles it. We approach 2 minutes to go, first half.
I don't know if you caught that one, Ian, but it was in the middle of the traffic. He came looking defensively, and Daniel just blasted him across the face.
Come out with a blitz on Nelson. West, pump fake. Daniels bit. West,
nice look.
Extra feed, and Jones rocks the rim.
Pretty basic basketball just then, but West getting into the middle of the floor. Good things will happen if you do two things. Get to the middle of the floor and go towards the basket.
1:45 to play and until halftime. Daniels leaves his feet. Pump fake, walks in a 3. Book it.
Big shot just then in the first half. You don't overemphasize it, but Watson nailing that shot from long range gives them a little more confidence, and now this is a big possession here. Trying to finish the half, St. Joseph's on a high note to get back into this game, keep it down to double digits.
Nathan Watson, second three-pointer of the day. Collegier. 12 points equals Auburn's largest lead of the afternoon as we approach 1 minute to go, first half. West for Nelson, shot clock at 8. Nelson, the floater.
How do you stop that? Boy, he's really perfected that shot. 7 or 8 foot jumper through the lane, but explosive to get to that point. Can really get to any spot on the floor when he puts his mind to it with the basketball.
Jameer Nelson averaging 19 points per game. He's got 5 here in the first half. Under a minute to go until halftime. Watson's got the touch. Side rim on a trifecta.
Got a 9-second differential right here. St. Joseph's needs to get a good look at the basket.
Collegier holds the ball, and Little Hughes Jr.
Auburn only with 5 team fouls also.
West, jump shot. No good.
He has a little short on the shot, hitting that front iron.
Auburn can hold for 1. Will Daniels do it? No, he takes it right to the rim. Count it! And a chance for 3.
Well, you touched on it. You think about the last shot, I think St. Joe's might have been thinking about that defensively, but Daniels keeps the pressure on with the basketball. One of the things he does so well, look at him trying to knife his way through and slash. I just don't know how he got the basketball, never mind go in, but get through the traffic just then.
7 points for Marquise Daniels. 6 boards. And Auburn with a chance to take its largest lead. Daniels hits on the free throw. Auburn 32, St. Joe's 19, 21.3 to go here until halftime. It's been Auburn from the very beginning. Constant pressure going towards the rim, and the defensive pressure has worn down St. Joe's.
They established two things early in this basketball game, and it continued for the entire first half, that we're going to defend Auburn, that is. We're going to defend St. Joe's on the perimeter, and we're also going to take the ball and try to get it down offensively on the blocks. They've been successful in both of those areas.
12 seconds left in the half. Last shot attempt. Will they get one? Foul call. The pass intended for Stachytis. And the reach-in will work against Donnie Colton.
No shots yet, though. Only the 16th foul.
9.1 remaining on the clock, and Nelson will check back in for St. Joe's, replacing Sazonov.
Clearly getting Nelson on the floor. Try to get him free with 9 seconds. Plenty of time to get a shot. Most important thing is getting the basketball cleanly in bounds, which they do.
Here's Nelson. 5 seconds left. Nelson through traffic. Kick out. Stachytis. Can't hit it. Side rim. It bounced around. And there's the buzzer. Cliff Ellis and his Auburn Tigers will go to the locker room with their largest cushion of the first half. 13-point disparity. 32-19. Auburn leads it. Let's go over to Darren Horton.
Well, Cliff Ellis, they said you didn't belong in this tournament. You've done a good job of proving them wrong in the first half. Talk about the defense.
Well, I tell you, we got to keep getting the ball inside, and defensively, we got to keep taking the threes away. We've dodged a couple of bones, but at the same time, our team's working hard on defense. We've gotten the ball inside for the most part. A time or two, we let it go. We got to make sure we pound it inside.
All right, thank you very much. Ian, let's go back to you.
Darren, thank you. Coming up, singular at the half, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg. We'll get you updated on all the tournament news, all the scores and highlights, a live look-in, and all the action going on in the NCAA tournament. That's coming up, singular at the half. End of the first half, Auburn leading St. Joseph's 32-19. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this message.
Hey, Smith, you get a raise?
No, I got an Optima.
Introducing the Kia Optima midsize sedan.
Smith got a raise and options.
With available V6.
VP?
10-year, 100,000-mile warranty.
Smith's taking over.
Smith. And a starting price around
$16,000. Watch your back, Smith.
Smith Worldwide.
It'll just look like you got a raise. The Kia Optima. Right now, get 0% financing or up to $2,000 cash back.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's a classroom where the know-how is free and the homework is fun. It's how to build something, or paint something, or plant something. The place that can take you from wondering how to knowing how. And the guaranteed low price every day to make every dollar work. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Morning, William.
CJ. Hey,
how you doing?
How you doing?
Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name.
Looks like somebody got a haircut.
Too short?
And they're always glad you came.
Yeah.
Hey, no, you can't drive. Sure. See you tomorrow, Bobby.
Can you come in and play? Oh.
Who can you count on? You know them by name.
It's the NCAA tournament site with live scores, updated brackets, and insight from the top coaches. CBSSportsLine.com or...
Reinhard Toyota is Central Alabama's sports utility headquarters. Come and see for yourself the all-new 2003 4Runner. It's larger, more powerful, and right now for only $24,997. And nowhere else can you buy the best overall value, the 2003 Sequoia, including leather, for only $31,997. Come in and drive away with the best deals on the best SUVs.
Reinhard Toyota, where you always get the best.
My daddy's the best daddy in the world. He helps me with my homework, and he takes me to dance class. And my daddy can also do magic. He uses a special box to get cable television without paying. And daddy says it isn't really stealing, because it's magic.
Report cable theft anonymously at cabletheft.com.
My daddy's a policeman. He puts bad people in jail.
Today on ESPN at 5, College Game Night with all the tournament news, highlights, and analysis. At 5:30, Tony Kornheiser and Michael Wilbon take on the sports world on Pardon the Interruption. At 6, SportsCenter gives you all the highlights, wraps up the day, and prepares you for tonight's action. All the tournament news and the rest of the day in sports on ESPN.
We have three games of today's tournament at halftime right now. We'll get you out to the action of that fourth one in progress coming up.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Hat. Singular's wireless polling allows you to get into the game.
Hi, everyone. Welcome once again to Singular at the Half. Greg Gumbel here in our New York studios, along with Clark Kellogg. The score at halftime, the Tigers of Auburn University leading St. Joe's 32-19. Auburn is a school that many questioned whether or not they should even be in the tournament because they hit the tournament having lost six of their previous nine. They're doing well today.
They really are. They're doing a nice job. Very efficient at both ends of the floor, getting the ball inside on offense and on defense. They've guarded the perimeter as well as it can be guarded.
All right, the one game that's in progress right now is a first-round action in the Midwest region. Top seed Kentucky with a 36-24 lead on the Jaguars of IUPUI as they approach halftime. Jim Nance and Billy Packer.
Kentucky has led throughout here, 36-24.
Lambert down inside on Estill with a little bit more size.
Kentucky shooting 50% from the field. Fitz with a jumper. And rattles home for the Cats.
Set play. Good two-man screen for Fitz. Fitz is such a versatile player. You know, you can put him defensively on a guy. Here he's guarding a guy like Murray who's bigger than he is. They're matching up in the zone right now. Bogan's running the baseline, shouting out the signals.
Stolen away, Hawkins reached in. He had an eye on it.
Oh, great move by Hawkins.
Finds pitch in the corner, three-pointer.
Excellent ball handling by Hawkins. Daniels running the floor. Everybody filling the lanes. They actually had a 4-on-2 there. Here's what I was talking about that run, Jim. You don't want to get down by 20.
Under a minute and a half remaining in the first stanza.
This zone causing some problems right here. Sanders, the best shooter, looking for a little room. Can't get it.
There's Murray. And well done with Estill's presence being felt. Nearly stolen away by Crenshaw. He's over the press row. Big. Estill with the dunk.
Boy, Crenshaw just missed picking that off by inches, Jim. What a hustle play. Young man hurt his ankle to start this game, then took a bang when he got caught in a solid screen, and then goes head and heels over this bench. He's a tough one, isn't he?
Look at this.
Look at this. Boy, he didn't give up anything there. He wanted right back out on the floor as well. 26-year-old former Navy man, ready to give it his all.
Doing it all. Could have even stopped and written a column on the way back. Minute to go in the half.
Now May in the game has got to make good decisions right here. He's on Hawkins, doesn't want to get that ball stolen. And Hawkins wants a piece of it.
Best matchup is Murray on Estill. Hawkins with the quick hands again. Oh, somehow got the pass to Finch.
What a pass. They had the matchup they wanted, Murray and Estill, and somehow didn't get the ball to Murray. They ought to give it to him right now, and they do.
The Kentucky run IUPUI tried to avoid.
Well, if I were Kentucky now, I would go ahead and switch Daniels over. Now they go back into the zone so that there's no one-on-one situation for Murray. Murray thought he was going to get a chance with Estill again.
Murray drives, lays it in. He's got some moves.
He sure does. He moved that ball over in his hand. Look at Hawkins go right through it.
Hawkins beats the buzzer and counts the basket. It's a three for the Cats as they head to the locker room.
And there's that 20-point margin I was talking about, Jim, with the three-point shot. Great job by Hawkins in both ball handling and then, of course, hitting that shot at the buzzer. He really showed some ball handling dexterity, didn't he, on these last three trips? That one for himself.
To free himself from a couple of jags. And he bangs home the three. We go over to Bonnie Bernstein.
Jim, Kentucky jumping out to a decisive lead. Tubby, how important has this been for setting the tone for the tournament?
Well, IUPU came out, wanted to take some time off the clock, which they probably felt a little bit outmanned, but we turned the ball over quite a bit. I thought their matchup created some problems. We had some easy looks, but we got our running game going. Big three there by Cliff to end the half to keep the momentum going.
Coach, thank you.
That's the end of the first half. The score, Kentucky 48, IUPUI 28. CBS Sports exclusive coverage. Continue after this message and the local station.
You know, we're never in the same place at the same time.
No, not really.
So we need a plan that allows us to talk. You know, as much as we want, all the time,
all the
whenever
time.
We want.
And then no extra charge.
With Singular's Family Talk plan, call each other for free with unlimited mobile-to-mobile calling. Get 5,000 night and weekend minutes to share, up to 3 additional lines, and up to 4 free phones.
We call it the Conley Brothers.
What's up?
What's up?
What's up plan?
Come in and find out how Singular fits you best.
Just feeling it, you know? It's hard to explain, like the taste of food cooked over an open fire. There's nothing like it.
Original Western Whopper is back. Crispy bacon and cheddar cheese with bullseye barbecue sauce. Come into Burger King now, because this offer ends soon.
We're the most successful anti-narcotics crew in law enforcement.
Call my lawyer.
Call your lawyer?
Mm-hmm. Ah! Whoa!
Let's roll!
Get the drug dog.
Get him, boy.
He got him.
I'm supposed to go into a building full of drunken cartel unarmed? That isn't fun.
Can I get an amen?
A man apart.
I don't know how you stayed alive this long.
Radar starts Friday, April 4th.
I swim the 200. I study sociology. I grind out laps. I cram for tests. I race nationals. I take finals. And when I finish, I'll be ready to start.
There are 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and thanks to continued support, Coca-Cola helps them pursue their dreams.
I have to focus, gather everything I've learned, all my successes, all my sacrifices, all my pain, and concentrate that energy into one moment. That's a moment I'll use every single day of my life. There are 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Think. Read. React. Struggle.
Succeed. Grow.
Every time we step on the floor, class is in session.
There are 360,000 NCAA student athletes.
And each one of us is getting to it.
The
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship begins Saturday on ESPN.
On this second day of the NCAA basketball tournament, we have four games, three of them at halftime. We'll take you out to that fourth live.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Hat. Singular's wireless polling allows you to get into the game.
Welcome back to our studios here in New York and a Singular at the Half, everyone. I'm Greg Gumbel, along with Clark Kellogg. Our score at the break, the Kentucky Wildcats with a 48-28 lead on IUPUI. And these Jaguars have run into a buzzsaw.
They certainly have. They've played valiantly, but Kentucky doing what they've done all year long, Greg. They use defense to fuel their power surges, and they're able to put points on the board like that.
All right. Other games are at halftime, but the one that has resumed in the second half is that the Fleet Center in Boston, first-round action in the East Region. Syracuse, a four-point lead on the Manhattan Jaspers. Let's take you there live. Vern Lundquist and Bill Raftery.
McNamara misses from way outside for Syracuse. The Syracuse Orangemen lead by four, 35-31. Their largest lead of the game was nine. They actually trailed at the outset by five. Turnovers have cost them dearly, and have helped keep Manhattan close.
They sure have. They've been very aggressive defensively, Manhattan, and doing a nice job finding people in this zone, changing the look each trip, getting good opportunities.
Got it. Rainbow. Bobby Gonzalez sets a high jump record with that one.
Unbelievable. He got over 4 feet on that shot.
Talk about vertical leap.
Well, he knows they're knocking at the door right now. This is what they've been effective with. 2-2-1, almost a walk in the backcourt there.
There's the pass to Dewaney, bounced to Warwick, and a foul is going to be called on Jack Kett.
Now, they're not going to give up anything easy. We saw kind of Elchick's foul in the end of that first half. They're going to be strong. Make sure you don't put it up on the glass.
That is the first foul on the senior, Justin Jack Kett, whose father Richard and grandfather Joe both played here. And Hakeem Warwick did not play all that much. He did start the game, but Jim Boeheim telling us yesterday, Bill, that he was bothered by an upset stomach.
It shows you how deep they are, though. They went to Josh Pace. Billy Eaglin, of course, has gotten a lot of minutes during the course of the year, but it's a different defense without him. And his length is across the wingspan. He covers lanes. That's what they don't have or have missed. Also, his shot blocking ability. And maybe a little smile out of Jimmy B if he can play a lot in the second half.
Successful trip to the line for Hakeem Warwick, and a back to a four-point edge now. As we played two in the second half, the number three seed Syracuse against the number 14 seed Manhattan.
Manhattan's been able to find the guy in the foul line. And a fourth will go to the baseline, and they've been able to step into the lane right across the elbow.
Jasper's winners are 15 in a row. Last loss to Fairfield back in February.
And a nice coverage by Dwaney.
Jenny Miner, empty pass. Nope, loose ball picked up by Syracuse. He's Anthony.
And that's the zone right there, the length. Fourth and Warwick.
Oklahoma State again will play the second game here. Roughly 2:35 start. The second of four. Miner picks up his second foul.
So as it was at halftime, Syracuse's lead is four, and they're just under 17 and a half to play in the second half. In Birmingham, first round South Region action, the Longhorns of Texas at halftime are leading the Bulldogs of UNC Asheville 36-26. We thank you for joining us here on Singular at the Half. We will send you back to Tampa for the second half of Auburn and St. Joseph's right after this.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half. Singular's wireless polling allows you to get into the game.
If you want to be voted an Automobile Magazine All-Star, you better be good. If you want a unanimous vote, you better be Mazda 6. Only Mazda 6, the car they said delivers high content of engineering and luxury features, got the thumbs up from all the judges. Oh, and these guys? No All-Stars here.
Yeah.
Lease an all-new Mazda 6i for $239 a month for 39 months with $2,539 due at lease signing.
Hey, Bob. You get a new haircut?
No.
Hey, Bob.
Hey.
Did you lose weight?
Huh?
New jacket, Bob?
Nope.
What's different? He finally asked his doctor about Viagra. Ready to ask your doctor about Viagra for the first time? Find out if a free sample is right for you. To learn more, visit Viagra.com.
Called the sitter, I walked the dog, and I saw the doctor.
Ask your doctor and see the difference.
It's the NCAA tournament site with live scores, updated brackets, and insight from the top coaches. CBSSportsLine.com or AOL keyword.
Guess who's now in business? It's Nology. You probably already know us from home for the smarter phone services we offer, for speedy and reliable internet access, and for quality cable television. Residential subscribers trust our great customer service, world-class technology, cost savings, and convenience. Now, your business can too. Nology. Let's do business.
If you've waited to make your next vehicle purchase, now is the time to
make your move.
Auburn Mazda has the all-new Mazda 6 in stock. Only $19,900.
Make your move.
Move on a Mazda Tribute. Zero APR, $1,000 below dealer cost. Both come with Mazda's four-year, 50,000-mile bumper-to-bumper warranty and free roadside assistance.
Make your move.
Make the short trip to Auburn Mazda and deal with a winning team, because
nobody beats an Auburn Mazda deal.
Because all we do is discount Mazda.
Today on ESPN at 5, College Game Night with all the tournament news, highlights, and analysis. At 5:30, Tony Kornheiser and Michael Wilbon take on the sports world on Pardon the Interruption. At 6, SportsCenter gives you all the highlights, wraps up the day, and prepares you for tonight's action. All the tournament news and the rest of the day in sports on ESPN.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the Men's Basketball Championship is sponsored by Chevy Trucks, the United States Army, Monroe, and by Busch Beer.
It's halftime at the St. Pete Times Forum in Tampa, Florida. And at the break, 10th-seeded Auburn in the East, leading number 7th seed St. Joe's 32-19. Welcome back, everybody. Ian Eagle along with Jim Spinarkle. First of four games today, this 7-10 matchup. That line has become even more blurred as the years go by. And to say that this would be an upset if Auburn actually pulls it out over St. Joe's, that's not a fair statement.
No, I wouldn't go there with that being an upset. And I think if you're St. Joe's, one of the things in the second half that you have to really focus on, I'm sure Phil Martelli talked about this, let's start plugging this ball down low, and especially with Nelson at the guard. Even if we commit some offensive fouls, push the ball into the middle of the floor and go towards the basket, make some things happen.
Take a look at the halftime numbers. Auburn didn't shoot it all that well, 43%, but St. Joe's really struggled, especially with the turnovers.
Absolutely. You look down deep, you know, have West in trouble right there, but then the points in the paint, Davis in particular, established himself down low, a good advantage there. But Daniels here we see leading 21 points, Auburn with the front court scoring. So really, I thought overall you have a classic situation where Auburn really effectively did what they're trying to do well at the offensive end.
And the backcourt, it's been a struggle. Nelson averaging 19 points per game, only 5 today. Delonte West not 100%. And Darren Horton, third member of our broadcast team, spoke with him moments ago, and West told him he is feeling very sore. That upper right ankle area. Davis, tie up. And the possession arrow favors St. Joseph's. Now, moments ago, Darren Horton had a chance to catch up with Phil Martelli.
Coach Martelli, your team's down by 13. You're shooting 29% in the first half. What do you do to get them on track offensively?
Well, we just have to keep believing in them. That's one thing. But certainly our missed shots have led to 10 fast break points for them. If we make some shots, we can get our defense more established.
All right, thank you very much. Ian, let's go back to you.
Well, it does start at the defensive end for St. Joe's, an area that Phil Martelli has preached from the beginning of his tenure 8 years ago. Carroll, jump shot, his first attempt of the day from the field, comes in the first minute of the second half. Daniels crosses over for the floater.
Boy, is he ever crafty with the basketball just then. A little bit of a slide, a little bit of a cut. And Carroll's struggling from long range to get his shots off, really not getting fresh looks at all.
10 points for Daniels. Auburn 34, St. Joseph's 19, just underway here in the second half. As St. Joe's cannot find its identity on offense. Mallon, a three. The freshman, 6'10", showing off his range.
A team that shoots the ball at about 38% from the three-point stripe just can't get good looks. Up until that point with Mallon, there haven't been many that they've been able to get the clear looks at the basket. Auburn was just terrific perimeter defense for that entire first half and a little bit into the second.
The heralded backcourt for St. Joe's has been held in check as Killingsworth puts it off the rim, no good. Nelson, smallest man on the floor with a rebound.
Going to try to pick it up a bit.
Weaving through traffic. Carroll, little contact on the outside. Wow, Farley had it blocked. Great extension by Davis. St. Joe's holds on to it.
Boy, did he ever come from a long way.
Nelson, penetration. High off the glass, and a circus shot for Jameer Nelson.
Now, all of a sudden, St. Joseph's starting to get a little bit of rhythm, maybe a little bit of confidence down the offensive end of the floor. As we just heard with Phil Martelli just then saying, let's get some confidence. Let's try to get something to build on. Maybe they can build on these two last possessions.
Auburn's lead is 10 off the entry pass. Contact Sazonov trying to defend on the inside. A look at the game summary. Auburn at 43% from the field. St. Joe's has improved to 32%. Auburn has controlled the glass most of the day.
But St. Joseph's with that 3-for-12 from three-point line is really not only the fact that they're not knocking them down as where they would like to, but they need to get better looks.
Killingsworth's feed got deflected. Here's Daniels on the perimeter. Plenty of time to work with on the shot clock. Kick out. Daniels puts it on the floor. And it came off Mallon out of bounds. Auburn retains it with 18 to shoot.
So important now for Auburn to see if they can be patient like they were for the most part of the first half. They were very, very good at making judgments whether to go full and blast or be good in the half-court sets.
Daniels roaming baseline. Carroll picks his pocket. Scrum for the loose ball. And a tie-up. Auburn will hold on to it. Possession arrow favors the Tigers.
Carroll was initially in trouble just then along the baseline, but the quick hands freed up that basketball, allowing him to get back into that play.
Shot clock is down to 12. Monroe will toss it in. Killingsworth breaks free for a layup and one. Sazonov, the foul on the inside. That's number three.
You try to steal points, and stealing points on the out-of-bounds plays, sometimes that can work in your favor. Just a little bit of a breakdown right here. The quick entry pass. St. Joseph's not ready to defend on the opposite side of the ball.
Marco Killingsworth, 8 points, 3 rebounds. Killingsworth, the best low post option on this Auburn team, a burly forward. And he completes the three-point play. 37-24, Auburn.
And both he and Daniels have 10 shots already attempted, so they're getting the basketball to their right guys, getting it on the blocks.
Dwayne Jones has come in to replace Sazonov in foul trouble. Just over 4 minutes elapsed in the second half.
And once again, a good matchup of Daniels and Carroll out front.
Off the back end, Jones. The backup center, the freshman. A raw offensive player, but he showed you a move on the interior.
Well, they try, St. Joseph's try to get the center position to play by committee. If they can get those three guys to chip in and get the numbers on average up around 10, and there's a quick turnover going the other way, a little out of control. One of the things Auburn has to be careful with right now.
Dead ball allows Delonte West to check back in. West, a polished offensive player who just is not himself right now because of the stress fracture. Right fibula, just above his ankle. He's been dealing with it for about 5 weeks. West, off the rim on a three. Jones, offensive rebound. He is surrounded. West, he'll clear it for Barley outside.
West was 1-for-6 in the first half, but that shot, he had 2 or 3 shots that just fell off the rim for him. His shot looks fine. He's just not getting it to go down for him.
Nelson in a crowd finds an opening as he puts it off the glass and in.
And that's what I touched on at the half. What Nelson has to really do is force the action. I know sometimes you can get yourself in trouble by going over and running over people, but I think St. Joseph's now has to take some chances at the offensive end.
Bird, fakes, almost lost the ball, dragged his foot, and another jump ball. Possession arrow to St. Joe's. The Hawks showing some signs of life early moments, second half. 9-point game.
Hey, well, see, when I mean I'm proud of you, I mean I'm really proud of you.
Dadgummit, little Joe.
Entertainment on the ranch sure has come a long way.
Hiya, Fly. How are you?
What would you expect from the best suburban yet?
Bring Miss Netta a visit, Paul.
You gonna get out here and help us?
Sure, Paul.
Paul, come on.
Chevy Suburban, like a rock.
With worn shocks can take 10 feet farther to stop. Next time you're in for tires or brakes, have your shocks checked as part of a Monroe Safety Triangle inspection. Monroe, ride safe.
When you were young,
you'll find yourself.
You'd go outside and play in the mud. Some things never change. Head for the mountains of Bush.
Maybe. Yes, sir!
The Masters is on CBS.
Jameer Nelson is the only returning starter on a team that went to the NIT last year, and he can absolutely take over games with his remarkable quickness.
That he can. I mean, he can put up points in a hurry. He had 39 against Dayton recently, so I'm sure that's going through his mind right now. How can I get involved more so in this basketball game? And don't think that Auburn's not thinking the same thing. You have to be smart, but you also have to be willing to take some chances, which he is.
Nelson is playing off the ball. Barley feeds it to him. Here's Nelson turning the corner. Kick out. Mallon open look. Three ball doesn't go. West offensive rebound and a reach in on Daniels.
See, there's Nelson at his best, though, and that's how St. Joe's will get those free shots. You saw that big drive to the basket. He noticed and recognized that there was nothing there. The path was closed. But guess what? Kick it to the outside and you'll get a shot.
And the difference now for St. Joe's first half to second half, they are getting better looks here in the early moments of the second half.
They just seem more confident. They're using the dribble a little bit better also.
Auburn still leads it 37-28. Nelson.
He's touched it twice in a row now. Looking for him on curls, looking for him on the cuts.
Here's West with 13 to shoot. Nelson against Bird. Flair to the corner. Barley will stroke it. Off the rim. Mallon tips the ball inside. Jones almost got it to go. And a push called on the interior.
Did Mallon ever make a strong effort to get to that basketball? Just the hand, just enough to free it up. A little bit of a reach. Once again, you look at the open shots, and you'll see here where Mallon comes in with the right hand, reaches in just to free it a little bit for Jones to kind of get a shot off, and nearly gets the ball to come up over the rim for him.
First foul on Marco Killingsworth. Free throw is good for Jones. 35% on the season. Out of Chester, Pennsylvania. And what a surprise he has been so far. 7 points. As John Bryant checks in, he'll replace the freshman, Dave Mallon. St. Joseph's chipping away, now trailing by 8.
Well, there's a ton of time left, and it really becomes a mental thing for St. Joseph's now.
Loose ball.
Oh, look at Nelson going to work.
Tip in. Bryant gets the roll.
Did you see Nelson move away from that ball? Because The Auburn player was trying to slam it against his leg so it would kick out of bounds. Great quickness by Nelson.
Pull-up jump short from Watson. Killingsworth had it knocked away. Robinson swinging the elbows. West trying to take it away. He does. And a foul on Robinson. Auburn is looking like a different team than the one we saw in the first half.
And you were right on it with Robinson with those high elbows swinging, not intently to hurt anybody, but West put his face right in it.
7-0. Hawks run. It's a 6-point game.
Well, the girls have been sharing a wireless phone.
Yeah, I could help you out here.
At Sprint stores, buy one A460 Samsung phone and get a second one free. Plus, get 500 anytime minutes to share for $65 a month with unlimited night, weekend, and PCS to PCS calling. PCS from Sprint, clearly a whole new way to look at wireless.
Retirement plans from the Principal Financial Group can prepare you for almost anything.
Yeah, you got it.
Retiring!
At the Principal, we're the nation's 401k leader. We offer mutual funds, annuities, and rollover IRAs, which leads to a secure, happy retirement.
Ten.
Ted, how'd you do it?
Planning.
For 120 years, the Principal Financial Group, we understand what you're working for.
It's far better to spend 15 seconds looking at this now than in 15 years wishing you had. Retirement. Loans. Insurance. AIG. We know money.
Warning. Do not attempt any of what you are about to see. Jackass the movie on DVD and video. If you loved it in theaters, you'll go nuts for this DVD with 5 hours of extras. Jackass the movie. Buy it on DVD and video March 25th.
The Morgans of New York City. The Mendozas of Fort Worth, Texas. Stu and Maggie.
Who's that?
With a bunch of steak quesadillas from Taco Bell.
A higher class of quesadilla has arrived. Taco Bell's steak quesadilla. Marinated carne asada steak and 3 rich melted cheeses. Upgrade to steak. Think outside the bun.
Auburn Tigers back in the NCAA tournament for the first time since the 2000 tourney, when they lost to Iowa State in the second round. St. Joe's last tournament appearance, a loss to Stanford in the second round in the 2001 NCAA tournament. Nelson now with 9 points. He's the high man for St. Joe's. Daniels has 10 for Auburn.
I love the way college basketball, the mood of a game can shift, the belief, the collective thought process, and the confidence that you can see just evolving with a basketball team. And clearly right now, this is St. Joseph's stage. Let's see what they can do.
Give and go. Nelson, count it. It's goaltending as Nelson was able to squeeze his way through towards the rim.
The question always becomes, how long can you hold on to the stage and keep the confidence? And they're right on it now. They understand Phil Martelli has really got them playing as a group finally and believing in themselves.
11 points for Nelson. It's 37-33 Tigers. Daniels goes behind the back with a dribble.
Nice screen by Robinson here. Good work by Bryant to let him know.
Daniels, push off. Did he get caught?
I think there's going to be a reach before the left elbow came out.
Tyrone Barley.
And I think this is the correct call here, Ian, too.
Barley with that on-the-ball defense. The game summary in a 4-point differential. New shot clock for Auburn to work with. Bird out front. Daniels comes to the ball.
And Barley holding that left leg a little bit right now out front.
9-0 Hawks run.
Good step out by Bryant.
Killingsworth, travel.
Now, does this look like the same Auburn team that was playing in the first half? To me, they don't. They look tentative at the offensive end. They're not getting the ball on the blocks as much as they did in the first half.
Nelson trying to catch Auburn napping. Flare to the corner. West, jump shot is good.
That is huge right there. Huge for the program, huge for everything that smells St. Joseph in this building right now.
Delonte West with the bucket and 11-0 St. Joseph's run. Auburn looking for something on the offensive end. It's Bird, rims out on a three. Jones up high for the rebound. And a loose ball foul against Auburn. You had Robinson and Davis in the area.
The one key thing about this was the fake, and look at the elevation. He's a left-handed shooter, and what that means is he's had problems west with shooting the basketball, and that's driven by your feet, and his right foot is the one that has given him the problems. That's his plant foot. He looked a little bit better just then with the strength of it.
5 second-half turnovers for Auburn. Robinson picks up his third foul for the Tigers. St. Joe's with a chance to tie or take the lead as we hit 13 minutes to go, second half.
I'm sure Phil Martelli was very disappointed in the first half, but now he's feeling good over there.
Nelson for the tie. Got it!
They have arrived. It took them a little while, but now St. Joe's is showing you how they play their style of basketball.
13-0 run. Nelson now with 13 points. He's the high man. High pass. Watson's got it. A jumper off the rim.
Look at Jones go to work on the glass. He's knocking his own players out of the way. He's just going after it. And here comes Nelson again. Little hold.
Out front, Nelson is fouled. Personal on Watson, his first. St. Joseph's and Auburn tied at 37 with 12:24 to go in the second half. The Hawks looking for their first lead since 4-3 early on. It's West. That won't go. Jones fighting for it. And Auburn controls it. St. Joe's has come at Auburn like a wave since the halftime break.
It's as if these teams switch uniforms at the half because they're both doing exactly to one another. Auburn in the first half, St. Joe's now in the second half playing with confidence, controlling tempo, controlling the game generally.
Last touch by St. Joseph's. We'll get a substitution. Pat Carroll checks in. And Tyrone Barley will take a seat.
That's a funny thing, basketball, Iowan. The first half there, Auburn was hoping that the first half never left as St. Joe's has come flying back with a 13-0 run. But in the first half, they wanted it to keep playing, didn't want to take a break. Now they can't really get their rhythm, and St. Joe's would love this thing to just keep playing all afternoon.
Monroe handles it against West. Shot clock at 12. Davis way outside.
Have to get something going towards the basket.
Here's Daniels off the glass. Smooth move by Marquise Daniels. Auburn's leading scorer. He's got 12.
So you have to figure it out quickly on the fly. Why is St. Joe's doing so well? They're being aggressive with the dribble. They're going towards the basket, and that's getting their free shot. Daniels did the same exact thing. Go towards the hoop.
Give and go. West on a kick out. Carroll's been searching. Off the rim. Jones can't handle it for St. Joe's. Here comes Monroe the other way.
St. Joseph's still getting the look that they wanted, though, with Carroll.
Pump fake. Kyle Davis, the big center. The fingertips of Monroe out of bounds, and another Auburn turnover. The Tigers leading the Hawks by two. A timeout with 11:14 to go in regulation.
Critics say Dreamcatcher is stylish, sinister, and suspenseful. A supernatural nightmare.
Jonesy, you be careful.
Be careful of what?
Dreamcatcher, rated R, now playing.
You taking that for heartburn?
Panel of experts recommend it.
Dose for dose, Tums Ultra neutralizes more acid than Pepsin Complete's antacid. Costs less. Nothing's faster. Just ask a real panel of experts.
If you're heading out there, I'll give you a tip. It's wild and it's far, and you're in for a trip. For just when you think it couldn't get rougher, the path goes crooked and the going gets tougher. But once you've traveled this far off the track, you won't settle for less. And there's no going back. The powerful Chevy Tahoe, like a rock.
Well, the girls have been sharing a wireless phone.
Yeah, I could help you out here.
Yeah.
At Sprint stores, buy one A460 Samsung phone and get a second one free. Plus, get 500 anytime minutes to share for $65 a month with unlimited night, weekend, and PCS to PCS calling. PCS from Sprint. Clearly, a whole new way to look at wireless.
Coming up immediately after the games, a special edition of College Game Night. Chris Fowler, Dick Vitale, and Digger Phelps. PTI follows at 5:30. We'll see you for 90 minutes of SportsCenter, then at 6.
Auburn holding on to a two-point lead over St. Joseph's, and talking with Cliff Ellis, head coach of the Tigers, yesterday, he told us that Marquise Daniels has been a tremendous leader for this team throughout the season, his senior season, and this is where leadership comes into play. Auburn 39, St. Joseph's 37. We approach 11 minutes to go here in the second half from Tampa. Carroll feeding the post for St. Joe's, looking for the tie. It's Jones. Puts it in. 9 points off the bench for the redshirt freshman.
Compared to the first half, St. Joe's is really established. They could not get anything going at the offensive end. In fact, Auburn put the clamps on him both down low and on the perimeter. Now, all of a sudden, the second half, St. Joe's is a comfortable basketball team on the floor. They're getting the options that they want.
Near turnover, Monroe looking for a timeout. It's a tie up.
Did not establish the possession quick enough to get that timeout. Good call from the officials. And Cliff Ellis continues to wonder what's going on with his team, where at the other end, Phil Martelli is very happy defensively. This team, St. Joseph's, they're the best team in the A-10. Their field goal percentage defense is fabulous. Now they're showing us in the second half why they got the reputation of a great defensive team. They didn't have that in the first half of this basketball game.
Possession arrow favors Auburn. That's the fourth tie-up that we've seen in the second half alone. Auburn's largest lead today, 13. St. Joe's has rallied all the way back. And they've done it with their shooting in the second half, 52%.
Let's see if Auburn can do it and get it going towards the basket. Here's a guy, Daniels, who has to take control.
Five to shoot, a three. Knocks it down.
Boy, right on cue, huh?
Marquise Daniels with a rainbow jumper.
Inside and outside, and I'll tell you, the confidence. He's the guy you got to put everything on his shoulders and see if he can just carry Auburn here for the last 10 minutes and 10 seconds or so.
15 for Daniels. High pass. West. It came off the official, and that's out of bounds.
He was standing out of bounds. If he's in bounds, it's okay. He's standing out of bounds, though. Make a little step up. He has the size advantage. Puts the ball, I'm not sure on purpose, through his legs, but nothing but the bottom. He ends up on his rear end. Pretty good effort there by Daniels.
Marquise Daniels played 1 year of high school basketball with Tracy McGrady at Mount Zion Academy. Daniels grew up not far from here, Orlando, Florida, about an hour and 20 minutes away. Killingsworth inside, a double team. Follow attempt doesn't go from Davis. He's had a couple of spectacular dunks so far today.
Auburn looking to get that ball down on the blocks. They were very effective doing it.
3-point Auburn lead. We are past the midway point of this second half. Carroll.
Not giving Carroll the look at all out front. Bryant may be able to score if he catches the basketball. They're not guarding him at all.
Nelson finds West across the lane. A dish. Carroll catch and shoot. No good. Pat Carroll still looking for his first points of the day. He comes in averaging just under 12 points per game.
Well, the problem when you're a scorer and you're a shooter from the outside, you haven't gotten good looks. His tendency is to rush just a touch. I think he rushed a bit on that shot.
Auburn leading by three, and Bird is bumped as he took it towards the lane. Near the conclusion of every NCAA tournament game, we'll select a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. To date, Chevrolet has contributed more than $8 million to the general scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. Tyrone Barley comes into the game, the second personal foul on Delonte West. Out of the corner, Bird can't get it to fall.
Good job by Garley just then. Ball hits the floor. You know you're doing something well defensively. If that ball comes off, hits the floor. Guys are blocking out pretty well.
West, a jumper. He buries it. A three.
Boy, does he ever look like a different player? It's amazing. I would have thought just the opposite for the second half. I would have thought that that high stress fracture would have tightened up a little bit on him. Now he seems like he's really rebought the confidence.
It's the right fibula of Delonte West, which is the concern as Daniels misses from the outside. Daniels able to track it down. Contact on the interior as Davis was able to catch it, trying to follow through.
Boy, did Jones ever make a defensive effort right there. You get down here, though, the big number here. West looks straight up, gets a little elevation, and knocks it back. Oh, the other end. They're starting to play underneath, the physical play. It's up for grabs. Go after the basketball. Good move there by Daniels to release that to Davis, too.
No foul called as Davis took a seat. Double team on Bird.
Look at that double team in the corner. Somebody's reaching, though. Might have been Bryant.
John Bryant was the second man in. And he'll get called for the personal. We are tied at 42. Third foul on Bryant. 8:11 to go, second half here in Tampa.
Well, Daniels has gotten involved. Let's see if Killingsworth can get involved also for Auburn on the blocks.
Davis comes towards the ball. Give and go. Daniels got it and one. Marquise Daniels able to redirect his body underneath the rim.
Well, good work on the out of bounds also. You try to steal a hoop or two. What they like to do is get the lob to Davis. You've seen him in the past dunk the basketball, but a good quick step in. A lot of times you forget to guard the guy taking the ball out of bounds.
Third foul on West. Daniels off the mark, and Davis was along that baseline out of bounds. So Auburn leads it 44-42. Daniels now with 17 points. High man for the Tigers.
Living up to the billing, huh? Solid player. Understands when he has to take over and really be an impact player at the offensive end.
West for the lead.
All right, look at Jones working it again.
Here's West slicing towards the rim and a block on the interior. St. Joe's holds on to it. Barley puts it on the floor and loses the basketball out of bounds. Timeout, 7:45 remaining. Second half, Auburn leads by two.
Okay, see how the trans side of the rails warm more than the other side?
Felt like a million. Felt like number one. Like a rock.
What are you handing down to your kids? Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
On HP technology in the production of perfect sound.
Papa John's presents a mouth-watering deal that'll put a smile on your face. Say cheese. Sticks. Free cheese sticks. When you buy a made-to-order large one-topping Papa John's pizza for just $9.99, John himself will toss in our delicious cheese sticks absolutely free. We start with Papa John's hand-tossed dough, garlic sauce, cheese made with 100% mozzarella, and two zesty sauces for dipping. Call your neighborhood Papa John's today and get free cheese sticks when you order a large one-topping pizza for only $9.99. We see you smiling.
Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's.
I'll get this. Getting a really low rate on this card.
Well, I hope it's a low fixed rate, like my Capital One No Hassle card.
Low and fixed? So, what's going to happen to my rate?
Get the Capital One No Hassle card for the nation's lowest fixed rate and no balance transfer fees.
What's in your wallet?
Passage
is intense. But if you complete the journey, you will find your destiny among the world's greatest warriors. The few, the proud, the Marines.
St. Joseph's trailed this one by 13 at the break. What has Phil Martelli's team done differently in this second half to get themselves back into it?
I think there are three things he's done. When I look at the second half here, I think interior defense at their end, they have not allowed Auburn to get the ball down in the blocks. I think he's got his team believing, and also they're attacking with the dribble at the offensive end.
Daniels feeds it down low. Davis went for the windmill finish, and he's fouled in the act.
You know what, Ian? That's an opportunity there where the foul was a good foul because you don't give up the easy one, but I think he could have gone quicker. You see him looking at defender Bryant. I think you really just want to take that straight to the goal. Don't be fancy and get the bucket right there.
Fourth personal foul on John Bryant. Also a good foul because Davis shoots it at 49%, and the first one is good. 7 points, three rebounds for the junior from Blakely, Georgia. Still developing as an offensive player. Second one came off the iron. Daniels has it knocked away by Nelson. Look at him change gears. And a foul call.
Arguably at the other end of the floor, too, by Davis not taking that dunk that quickly on. You give up 2 points right there on one missed free throw, believe it or not. Daniels thought he was bumped a little bit right there, but watch Nelson coming down the floor. Watch him create body contact. The good drivers and the good guys who go to the basket who are effective at getting to the line really understand how to use their body first and shoot second.
Jameer Nelson, who would have been the Atlantic 10 Player of the Year if not for some guy named David West.
All of a sudden, David West appears, huh? Great year for him, wasn't it?
And for the program, Xavier as well, as Auburn leads at 45-43. We come up on 7 minutes to go. Killingsworth for the Tigers. Against Bryant, playing with four fouls. Killingsworth has it intercepted. West on a bounce. Here's Barley.
Barley looks like he's struggling a little bit, running up and down the floor. He keeps hobbling on the left leg, the left knee. Clearly, he didn't take that ball and go with it, though.
Delonte West, one-on-one with Bird.
They learn how to play with pain at St. Joseph's, huh? You're West and Barley. And they're trying to run it through West now. It's interesting. All of a sudden, he's becoming the option that he was during the year. First half, you didn't see him handle the ball that much as he's doing right now. He's really must be feeling a whole lot better.
West turns the corner. Good explosion towards the rim. But it was blocked underneath. Barley intercepts like a free safety.
Oh, sure was. Over the top, keeping his eye on the ball. Great play defensively by Barley.
And St. Joe's will take a timeout. 6:26 left to play in regulation. Auburn leading St. Joe's by a bucket.
What is it?
Pixie dust.
Pixie dust.
Pixie dust?
Magic self-healing server pixie dust.
How's it work?
Server goes down, sprinkle on the pixie dust, servers back up. Use it regularly and servers solve their own problems. Easy.
I like it.
What's it cost?
It's cheap.
Cheap.
Soy-based.
Soy-based.
Biodegradable.
Looks like we got a winner.
Auburn up 45-43 over St. Joe's. Jimmy, you mentioned just a few moments ago that Barley looked a little tentative trying to run around. Darren Horton just informed us that it's a knee contusion. He banged knees with a teammate. But Barley will remain on the floor for the Hawks.
I think it happened, too, when he played the defensive move against Daniels down the other end of the floor. There was three guys in on the collision. That may have been when he got that one.
Plenty of time to work with on the shot clock. 22 seconds. Nelson against Bird. Carroll back in there. Here's Carroll on the perimeter. Off the rim for three. It would have given St. Joe's the lead.
You got a pretty good look going to his right as a left-handed shooter. A little more difficult to get your strength going that way.
He's now 0 for 4 from the field. Monroe trying to get penetration, cannot. Auburn with just 13 points here in the second half. Byrne, wide open look. Can't get the three to drop, but Killingsworth tracks it down, weak side.
Killingsworth just knows how to be around the basketball.
Spin move, Killingsworth met there defensively, and he missed it on the interior. Jones able to clear it.
Jones just owns the real estate underneath the basket right now. He has done everything that St. Joseph's has asked of him at the defensive end, rebounding the basketball, making himself a big opportunist down there.
Spread the floor. We come up on 5 minutes to play. Barley on the perimeter. Shot clock is down to 10.
See if they can get it going towards the basket.
Nelson looking to make it happen. Fade away. On target. We are tied at 45. Just under 5 minutes to go. 7th seed St. Joseph's 45. 10th seeded Auburn 45 in the East Region. St. Joe's has battled all the way back, trailing by as many as 13. Killingsworth has just given Auburn a two-point lead with that lefty lay-in.
First half, the beginning of this basketball game, that was the MO right there for Auburn. They've gotten away from it in the second half. They've not been allowed to get the basketball on the blocks where they were effective in the first. And St. Joe's down there in fairly comfortable at the offensive end.
11 points for Killingsworth. Jones trying to use the glass. Tip in by Nelson. Smallest man on the court, able to get the bucket.
It turns out to be a little bit of a force by Jones somehow, and you touched on it. Nelson squeezes his way through the big guys and gets that hand up.
18 points, 8 rebounds for Nelson, who's listed at 6 foot. Killingsworth using the glass. Killingsworth has been a terror on the inside.
He's done a fabulous job of establishing strong position before they get to a point where they can enter the basketball with him.
13 points for Marco Killingsworth, and the officials checking at the scorers table right now. A timeout has been called. 3:55 left to play. Auburn with a two-point lead on St. Joe's.
Bacardi Silver Premium Malt Beverage. 5% alcohol by volume. Yeah. Your night just got more interesting. Now with a splash of orange.
This pancake, it looks just like Mom. You gotta see this.
Now we can. PCS Vision from Sprint, you could do more. Like take, send, and receive full-color pictures right on your phone on the largest enhanced nationwide PCS network.
You see, doesn't it look like her?
Thanks. You're welcome. Bon appetit.
I can't.
PCS Vision from Sprint. Clearly, a whole new way to look at wireless.
Whatever your groove, we'll be there.
So, you're hanging up the whistle, eh, Coach?
Yeah, kind of hard to believe.
So, can a girl buy you dinner? Coach, sorry, could you help me with something?
Sure.
This goes up there.
At Applebee's, we do our best to be part of the neighborhood.
What is it?
This is a business reality detector. It sniffs out overpromises and exaggerations.
Does it work?
Try it.
Keeney, what's up with the supply chain overhaul?
Everything's on schedule.
Fuller, how's the wireless thing going?
Under budget.
Phil, what do you think?
I don't think. I'm just a yes man.
Works.
Auburn 49, St. Joseph's 47. We take a look at the game reset. Fouls, and they become so key down the stretch here as St. Joe's already has committed 7, Auburn with 6. And the possession arrow favors the Hawks.
And both of these teams fairly equal percentage-wise for the season with free throw shooting in the 65-68 range. So neither one of these two teams dominated the line versus the other.
Here's Nelson with his team down by 2. Swatted away. Kyle Davis averages 3.5 blocks per game.
And he's usually the second guy in is really the most effective shot blocker. And Davis just then just roaming the turf underneath the hoop.
Career block shot leader at Auburn as West is fouled on the perimeter by Lewis Monroe. Time to check out the CBS Sportsline stat of the game, and it's points in the paint. Tight one, but a lot of it has to do with St. Joseph's getting back in to competition in that category in the second half. Get complete tournament stats at CBSSportsLine.com or America Online, keyword CBS Sportsline.
And keep in mind that number that we just touched on a moment ago, in the first half, Auburn was up 16-8, so it was a double the points in the paint. So it really has changed here in the second half.
Both teams are now in the bonus. 17 fouls apiece. One-on-one situation as West converts on the first. Here's the second. 10 points for Delonte West, an 81% shooter. This game is knotted up at 49. Auburn has led by as many as 15 early stages second half. Monroe with a pass off for Bird. The senior puts it on the floor. Ball movement.
That's Barley guarding Daniels. Also, size advantage to Daniels. He just can't catch the basketball other than that outside. Let's see if he can try to get a shot off. It's off his foot for a moment.
Shot clock down to 5. Bird nails the 3.
Auburn almost gets a break there because the ball nearly went out of bounds off Daniels' foot. And a good track and a real good recovery there to take the lead.
Derek Bird, a streaky shooter, just hit a big one. Under 3 minutes to go. 52-49 Auburn.
The decisions down the stretch, so important to make sure the guys you want making the decisions with the basketball touch the ball.
Daniels defending West. Timer down to 10. Barley for Nelson, 7 to shoot. And a foul out front on Bird. Free throw upcoming for Nelson.
Well, West trying to guard defensively there, not quick enough to get out on Bird, and Bird just straight away takes him, to this point, the biggest shot in this basketball game.
Jameer Nelson at the free throw line. He's got 18 points. Auburn 52, St. Joseph's 50. 2:35 to go here in the second half. Jameer Nelson with 19 points, the high man for St. Joseph's. He can cut the Auburn lead to 1, and Nelson has led the charge for the Hawks here in the second half.
Not necessarily iron from a scoring perspective, but we got to see how often Nelson touches the basketball and Daniels at each of their respective ends of the floor. Those two guys, they may not have to score the points, but they better get some touches to make some decisions.
Here's Daniels. Outside for Bird, just hit a key 3. Blocking foul along the baseline on Tyrone Barley of St. Joe's.
May have been a touch late getting there to establish the position. It was a great thought process, but just not quick enough. Watch the foot come out. You see the body move. That's a very good call from the officials.
And it sends Derek Bird to the free throw line. He's the best free throw shooter on the team.
Right at 80% on the season.
Third foul on Barley. Bird from Ypsilanti, Michigan. His father's name, amazingly enough, is Larry. And he lives on Boston Avenue in a greenhouse.
Keep going.
These are not made up facts. And now he's at the free throw line. First one's good. Live telecasts of NCAA men's tournament games are available right now online and on demand over the internet. To find out more, go to NCAAsports.com. Second free throw coming for Derek Bird.
A big shot for Bird. A big box out also.
2 out of 2. He nails both. 54-51, Auburn. We approach 2 minutes to play.
Tendency would be to think 3 because you're down 3, but you have to think going towards the basket first.
Nelson using the high screen set by Bryant. Here's West. He's come on in the second half. Bryant, ball movement. Nelson against Bird. Nelson hanging in the air. Side rim. Tip ball controlled by Davis of Auburn.
And well defended by Bird. He sat on the right side, the right shooting hand of Nelson, never allowing him to get a good shot off.
Daniels for Davis. Lost the ball. It was Nelson who got a piece of it on the way up.
Is he ever quick defensively?
And a huge turnover with a minute 36 to go. West pump fake. Daniels there defensively. And Phil Martelli wants a timeout for St. Joe's. We'll step aside. 1:32 left to go. A three-point disparity.
Ask your doctor today if Lipitor is right for you.
If someone wrote a book about your life, would anyone want to read it? Navy, accelerate your life.
Auburn holding on to a three-point lead, but not in a real tough situation, holding on to the basketball because Nelson came over, jarred the ball just a little bit, lost control right there, going towards the basket. Davis, an opportunity here for St. Joseph's to be very patient with the basketball. Still 20 seconds and change on the shot clock.
Each team with eight fouls. Auburn with three timeouts remaining. St. Joe's with two.
Let's see if Nelson can break somebody down, Bird off the dribble, and free one of the shooters. If he has a path to the basket, you obviously take it and draw people to you.
Hawks down by three. Shot clock down to four. And a foul called out front.
How about the crossover dribble going through the legs that trip? Bird with the foul. Nelson very, very quick with the basketball. And a lot of times going through your legs can be a showboat move. Not there. It was effective because it had a purpose.
Game summary. St. Joe's has gotten their shooting percentage way up here in the second half. It was a real struggle on the offensive end for the Hawks in the first half. And Nelson has been a big reason why. Free throw is good. St. Joe's down by two. That was the fourth foul on Derek Bird, who is Auburn's best on-the-ball defender, and his assignment is to deal with Jameer Nelson.
Keep in mind the perimeter players right now, Barley, Nelson, and West for St. Joseph's, all shoot the ball around 77% from the free throw line or better. So they got two guys that can shoot it at 80%.
Coming down to the wire, a minute five left. Here in Tampa, first round action from the East Region. 10th seeded Auburn leading number 7 St. Joe's by one. Davis puts it on the floor. Kick out for Monroe.
Who wants the basketball? Who wants to get the shot off? So far, no one's stepping up.
Bird, baseline. Caught along the baseline, and Jones blocked it away. Out of bounds. St. Joe's has got it.
Not only did Jones block that shot, but he also had that presence of mind to tip the basketball towards one of his teammates.
St. Joseph's has tied this game five times in the second half. They have not led since 4-3 in the opening minutes. 45 seconds left. Nelson handles it for the Hawks, trailing by one.
And Nelson's thinking right now, make them play me with the ball.
Nelson challenging, knocked around. Nelson got it back amazingly. 15 to shoot, 27 seconds to play, and a timeout. Auburn with a 54 to 53 lead. St. Joe's has the ball when we come back.
Manager, register 5.
Hey, we're out of...
No, we're not. It's like I think it, and it happens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
.NET Connected software helps you connect your supply chain. That's software for the agile business. From Microsoft.
Cliff Ellis has lost some heartbreakers in his day in this tournament. You might remember 1990. He was the head coach at Clemson when UConn knocked off Clemson at the Meadowlands in New Jersey. Tate George with that corner jumper in the East Regional semifinal. A classic.
I remember that one very, very well. What a classic it was.
Right now, Ellis's team is up by one with 27.8 remaining. And another timeout taken. We'll come back with the finish in a moment.
Ask your doctor today if Lipitor is right for you.
When my gang eats out, it's five different stomachs, five different stomach problems. But we don't need five medicines. We just need one. Pepto-Bismol. For heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, nausea, and diarrhea. Think pink. Think Pepto.
Auburn on top of St. Joseph's by one with 27.8 remaining. Phil Martelli's team has not lost consecutive games this season. You see the trends so far throughout the day. What is St. Joe's looking to do here?
Well, obviously, they get the ball to Nelson. They want to space the floor. I think one of two things. Now, you think of Nelson, if he's got a path going towards the basket, but keep in mind, the shots have been lofted pretty high, so they've been difficult traffic-type shots going to the basket. This is where the perimeter shooters are so important. Watch for the flares and the long-range shots.
Shot clock down to seven. Nelson. Yes! Jameer Nelson with the leaner. He's got 24. First lead for St. Joe since 4-3. And Auburn wants a timeout with 11.9. St. Joe's up by one. Final seconds when we come back.
Well, well, well. What have we got here?
In BASIC, everyone tells a different story.
What happened out there?
Wait, don't say it. I'll tell you.
But there's nothing more shocking.
I know who you are.
Than the truth.
They're dead, aren't they?
It's not like that. It's not.
BASIC is a thrill ride with a twist you won't believe.
Woo-hoo.
Seductive and electrifying with non-stop action.
Am I scratching your surface yet?
John Travolta, Connie Nielsen, and Samuel L. Jackson.
Why are you shooting?
You see what happens when you lie?
BASIC, rated R, in theaters March 28th.
A huge shot by Nelson getting through the screen, and now he pulls up. He had had troubles getting to the glass because you see 34 in orange, Davis jumping up. Great recognition by Nelson, understanding the play, understanding the fact that if you have to pull up from 8 feet, you knock it down from there. Don't try to be a hero and go all the way to the basket.
And another timeout called with 11.9 remaining. St. Joseph's 55, Auburn 54. We're coming back to Tampa after this.
Taco Bell Steak Quesadilla. Marinated carne asada steak and three rich melted cheeses make this one high-class quesadilla. Upgrade to steak. Think outside the bun.
When my gang eats out, it's five different stomachs, five different stomach problems. But we don't need five medicines. We just need one. Pepto-Bismol. For heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, nausea, and diarrhea. Think pink. Think Pepto.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's a commitment. A commitment to having the lowest possible prices every day. And not just a promise. It's the assurance of a price protection guarantee. It's a reminder of just how smart you really are. It's a little extra change in your pocket. And the know-how to make every dollar work. It's more than a store. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
The Auburn Tigers are looking for their seventh straight first-round victory. But they trail St. Joseph's by one with 11.9 remaining.
And clearly you look at this and Cliff Ellis has a decision. Do you wait, as Wisconsin-Milwaukee did last night against Notre Dame, for the very last second shot? But I don't believe in that. I believe that you really run yourself out of chances there. I catch it and I make something happen quickly right now. And I don't wait for the last second shot. Let's see what happens.
Daniels with Auburn down one, a three. Knocks it down.
Wow, was that ever big and confident at the same time.
6 seconds left. Marquise Daniels calmly hits the trifecta to give Auburn the two-point lead. Timeout. Daniels has 20.
You know, we're never in the same place at the same time.
No, not really.
So we need a plan that allows us to talk, you know, as much as we want, all the time,
all the
whenever
time.
We want.
And then no extra charge.
With Singular's Family Talk plan, call each other for free with unlimited mobile-to-mobile calling. Get 5,000 night and weekend minutes to share, up to 3 additional lines, and up to 4 free phones.
We call it the Conley Brothers.
What's up?
What's up?
What's up, plan?
Come in and find out how Singular fits you best.
Hey, guys, welcome to Jiffy Lube. Nice car.
It's not a car. It's the Bearmobile. Yeah. It takes care of us. We take care of the Bearmobile.
Every 3,000 miles.
Don't worry, fellas. The Bearmobile's in good hands.
Make sure you make it to your next road game. Trust your car to the top team in the business, the J Team.
Bearmobile is good to go.
Thank you. All right.
Bear stink!
Get that chicken!
Jiffy Lube, the well-oiled machine.
Daniels using the 6'6 frame to get over Barley, who is at 6'1. You're not going to go dribbling by the shorter guy, but you can surely pull up and know that you'll get your shot off. Look at the snarl. I mean, that's a confident snarl right there. Big-time shot by Daniels, the leader of this Auburn squad.
No timeouts remaining for either team. Auburn 57, St. Joseph's 55, 6 seconds left here in Tampa.
But Auburn does not want this ball going over the top of this full court pressure. That's where they make an adjustment. Good move.
They get it into Nelson. 4 seconds left. Nelson using his speed. 2 seconds. Nelson gets hit with half a second remaining.
And clearly you have to give spacing on the drive to the basket. A lot of people say bury the whistles and let the play end the game. I'm a big believer that if a guy goes through the lane and gets bumped, as Nelson did, you have to blow the whistle or you're taking an advantage away from the offensive player. That is a great step-up call from the officials.
Third foul on Kyle Davis. Nelson, 77% free throw shooter. He is 5 of 6 from the line today. He needs a pair. The junior gets the roll on the first.
Do you ever want your shoulders going towards the basket in these situations? And by that I mean you get your body going towards the basket. The tendency is to be nervous at the line. Get that little shoulder going towards the basket and your follow through and hope for the follow through and the roll.
First team All-Atlantic 10 performer for the tie. Kevin!
Doesn't get any better than this.
No timeouts remaining. Daniels throws it in. Monroe! Oh, it's a go! Off the window at the horn. We are going to overtime. 57-57 Auburn St. Joe's.
When you serve billions of farm fresh eggs, billions of cups of coffee made with some of the world's finest beans, and billions of biscuits made with real buttermilk.
Egg McMuffin, hash brown, and a large coffee, right?
Right.
You're bound to have billions of regulars.
When he first walked in the room, people were skeptical. They didn't know what to expect. It's like Malibu goes to Harlem.
He's trying to do something new.
Hip-hop, rock, pop, soul. Imagine if you combine all of those into one thing.
This is happening right now.
I'm just doing my thing. What's my thirst? Music. What's yours?
Ooh, that's hot.
Marquise Daniels, a three-pointer to put Auburn up by 2, but Jameer Nelson, fouled with half a second remaining in regulation, knocks down a pair of free throws, and this is where we stand. 5 minutes put on the clock for overtime. Auburn and St. Joseph's 57 apiece. First time Auburn will play in OT this season. We start the extra session. The seventh seed, St. Joseph's in the East, tied with the number 10 seed, Auburn, 57-57 at the end of regulation. And Auburn controls the tip with Davis.
The trick now is to forget about all the emotions, especially Daniels, because I think he thought he had himself a game winner. Let's see how he reacts now in the first minute or two, because he will get some touches.
First of 4 games today here in Tampa. What a way to open up. Monroe trying to find a screener. Here's Daniels on the perimeter. Daniels along the baseline. High arcing delivery. It got popped up in the air.
Not sure who got it. That's the problem. The officials trying to work it out.
And they will say that Auburn holds on to the basketball. Last touch by Jones.
Jones was a factor in the second half and has played very, very well underneath the glass of St. Joseph's. They're another factor closing in defensively.
Shot clock is at 11 for Auburn. 4:34 remaining. We are in overtime. Auburn and St. Joseph's tied at 57. Tigers have the basketball with 11 seconds on the timer.
The first half of this basketball game belonged all the way to Auburn. The second half of the basketball game, St. Joseph's fought their way back into it. Your guess is as good as mine right now as who's going to own the overtime.
Monroe makes his move. The leaner off balance doesn't go. Davis has the rebound, and he's able to save it for Killingsworth. New shot clock for Auburn. Monroe slowing things down one-on-one with Nelson for St. Joe's.
Daniels getting involved.
Daniels the curl towards the rim, running one-hander, no good. Fight for the loose ball. Who's got it? Last touch by St. Joe's. Auburn retains possession. Tyrone Barley got a piece of it right along that baseline.
Daniels goes to that basket. A lot of guys are jumping at him. That's why he may have some opportunities for putbacks.
Off the lob, deflected ball. Davis has got it. Nelson the step in. And he knocked it out of bounds.
Now, if the St. Joseph's fans across from us had whistles, they would have all blown the whistle there because I think they thought that Davis walked with this basketball at half court. Yeah, he sure did. He took a couple of extra steps right there. And that's why the entire red shirts in the body over there, St. Joseph's fans all stood up.
Just about a minute gone by in overtime. This is still the first possession for Auburn. Daniels way outside. Bird looking to break free. He cannot. It's Davis on a feed for Bird. Back in against West. Double team comes. Bird lost his footing for a moment.
Might be a 3-second violation, though.
It is.
With the anticipation of a shot going up, the closure by St. Joe's, and Cliff Ellis is understanding very strongly right now why St. Joseph's has the reputation that they do defensively. They are just shutting people down and making it awfully difficult to get anything, a fresh look, a clean look. There's nothing there for Auburn in the first minute or so here.
This season, St. Joseph's limited opponents to 59 points per game. Up in the air, Nelson on a kick out, gets it back from Barley. A three. It down.
Nelson is in rhythm as well as you can playing basketball right now, but Barley with a terrific decision and unselfish play to let Nelson get the ball back in a spot where he's comfortable shooting it. Still have to start going to the basket if you're Auburn.
On a spin move, Killingsworth, and St. Joe's wanted a travel.
Once again, it was Jones stepping in, but a terrific recovery just then by Killingsworth. The ability as a lefty to get that shot off in traffic.
60-59, St. Joseph's in front, 2:48 to go in OT. West against Daniels.
Can he put the ball on the floor and go by Daniels would be a question in this overtime.
Nelson.
West may not need to go by anybody if Nelson steps up as he is. He has taken over this basketball game. He's done it before for St. Joseph's. And he's doing it again.
32 points for the point guard, Nelson. Largest lead of the day for St. Joe's. It's 4.
And 39 once again against Dayton recently in their tournament.
On an entry feed. Good stepping. Bryant hits the deck.
And he calls timeout at the same time. But defensively, it can't be anything less than impressed with the St. Joseph's effort.
We'll take a break. St. Joseph's up by 4 on Auburn.
Somewhere, a manager needs someone to deliver a 12-ounce sirloin and a slab of baby backs to the couple at table 5. Chop, chop. Nearby, a friendly server needs a good job. That's where we come in. Employers call 888-MONSTER. Post your job and find the right person for it. Because now, blue collar, white collar, no collar. Monster works for everybody.
Just feeling it, you know? It's hard to explain, like the taste of food cooked over an open fire. There's nothing like it.
Original Western Whopper is back. Crispy bacon and cheddar cheese with bullseye barbecue sauce. Come into Burger King now, because this offer ends soon.
The seventh seed in the East, St. Joseph's, leading the 10th seed, Auburn, 63-59 with 2:10 remaining in overtime. The game reset. Auburn still has a timeout to work with. St. Joseph's, none remaining. And the team foul, St. Joseph's with 8. Auburn is already over the limit. Jameer Nelson, 32 points. He had 39 in the Atlantic 10 tournament semi loss to Dayton. He has scored the last 14 points for the Hawks. He has completely taken over.
And Auburn looking to pick up wherever they can right now. 2 minutes, a little bit more than 2 minutes left in this basketball game. At start, the time now is to come out and defend. And this is where Nelson becomes very effective. A great matchup with him and Bird at the point right now.
Nelson handles it.
A little high screen.
Nelson uses it. 13 to shoot. Another one from Jones. Nelson, step back. The rim, and Davis controls it, gets it ahead for Daniels.
Chris
goes around West and squares it through.
You see that little crossover just then when he caught the basketball. Open floor.
22 for Marquise Daniels. St. Joseph's with a 2-point lead over Auburn. A minute 24 to go in overtime.
Notice the spacing right now with St. Joseph's. It's Nelson out front with a 4-player spread. Little high screen coming now, so watch Nelson trying to take the ball towards the basket and also look for spray out shots out on the perimeter.
Bird defending Nelson, goes by him. Kick out. Barley with 8 to shoot. Backs it out. Shot clock is down to 6.
Has to go quickly.
It's all Nelson right now. High floater. Front rim. And rebounded by Auburn's Davis.
Don't think shot blockers don't play an impact part of this basketball game when they don't even block a shot, but they sure do alter them.
Feeding in the post area. Killingsworth. Double team comes. Cutter. Daniels. To go. And a foul. Auburn with a chance to take the lead at the free throw line.
Is Daniels ever stepping up in the crunch right now? Going down the floor earlier, we see him slam the basketball in the break, and then Killingsworth makes a terrific pass down the middle. The confidence, the concentration to get body first and then shot second.
45.2 remaining in OT. 24 points for Daniels, but 1 of 3 from the line for the lead. He converts. 64-63 Auburn.
Buckle up, here we go again.
9.5 second differential, shot clock to game clock.
And this is where Martelli is very comfortable with Nelson on the floor, just directing traffic.
Not on the perimeter. Barley puts it on the floor. West forced to give it up. Bryant inside. Jones battling for it. And last touch by Auburn with 10 to shoot. St. Joe's will hold on to it. 19.9 left at OT. And Pat Carroll will come back in for the Hawks, replacing Bryant.
Bryant found himself on the floor just then. I thought he made a good move, too. He caught the basketball. There was no one initially behind him, and he just rolled towards the basket. But did Auburn as a team ever react big time?
St. Joe's down by a point. Barley on the perimeter. 7 seconds to shoot.
Davis is going to try to block everything going towards the basket.
Offensive foul on Barley, fending off as Monroe took the bump. What a crucial play in the final seconds of OT, 14.2.
And now you clearly extend if you're St. Joseph's right now. You're down the point, and watch the arm come out. It's a good call. Position was there, arm extends. That's the easiest call for an official because you see the extension. Now you go for a quick steal right here if you're St. Joseph's, and you play the fouling game.
They get it in. Watson back for Daniels. Over to Watson.
Oh, a lot of time going off the clock, though, right now by Auburn.
Playing keep away, and in addition, they get it to the best free throw shooter on the team, Derek Bird. Daniels shoots it at 68%, Watson at 55%, and St. Joseph's could not foul either one of those players. Bryant has just fouled out for the Hawks.
couple of extra seconds disappear, though, because St. Joseph's doesn't go for the first guy. When Daniels had that basketball, I thought at 68%, there you're not really looking to play percentages at that point, Ian. You have to play the clock. You go after the first guy you can get and foul him so you don't lose the clock. The clock is your enemy right now.
8.5 remaining. St. Joe's thought Auburn had taken a timeout. They have not. Auburn 64, St. Joseph 63. We are in overtime in Tampa, Florida. Derek Bird, 80% from the free throw line, a transfer from Central Michigan. He has been a senior leader for Cliff Ellis's team. First one. Back of the iron. No timeouts remaining. So St. Joseph's, on a made free throw, will have to rush down the floor in a hurry off a miss. You could have a chaotic situation. 8.5 left in OT. Auburn up by one. Here's Derek Bird. 2-point lead for the Tigers.
Here we go.
Nelson brings it across. 4 seconds left. Kick out West. Carroll doesn't have a point today. It'll stay that way. Out of bounds. It's over. Are they going to put time on the clock?
No, they're going to talk about it, that's for sure.
The Auburn Tigers trying to make their way towards their bench.
May have been a whistle before the horn just then. Would not be surprised to see them put a little time on the clock right now.
Both teams huddling up.
Here's the shot by Carroll. Let's see. Ball does not touch. It goes out of bounds. Clearly, there's some time on the clock when that ball goes out of bounds. You'll probably see in the 0.4 of a second type of situation right now.
And the officials going over to the monitor to take a look at it themselves. They can look at the monitor. Last second situations at the end of regulation or at the end of OT.
Now keep in mind though, from a scoring perspective across the way, it's not when this ball really hits the floor, even though you would think that it's when the whistle is blown, when the official makes the call. So now it's hitting the line right there. Officials making the call and down low, and really, I would say there's a little bit of time left in this particular game.
And they are going to put 0.7 back on the clock. 0.7 of a second. Martelli wants an explanation. Steve Wilmer, Curtis Shaw, Rick Hartzell, the officiating crew. First of 4 games here in Tampa.
I think this officiating crew had a tough game to do this afternoon for the first one here. I think they've done a marvelous job making the correct calls.
And it gives both teams some time to at least chat things over as they put time on the clock. 0.7 of a second left.
Auburn basketball.
St. Joseph's.
That's smart. Just get it up in the air and look for a bat.
And that's it. The Auburn Tigers hold on in overtime. Their 7th straight first round victory. And they did it the hard way. 65-63 over St. Joseph. So the number 10 seed in the East moves on to the second round. They will meet the winner of the Wake Forest East Tennessee State game, which is coming up momentarily. Chevrolet, most valuable players of the game. Marquise Daniels, 25 for Auburn. Jameer Nelson, what an effort. 32 in a losing cause for St. Joseph's. 65-63. Auburn wins it in overtime. Greg Gumbel will be coming up. Scores, highlights, the rest of the day.